Hello logical people, GKB here. Welcome to the fifth video of Next.js fundamental tutorial series. In the last video, we learned what is a useEffect hook. We also learned the three ways of using useEffect hook and how to use it in tandem with useState hook. Now, in this video, we will learn and understand how useRef hook works and when to use it. In my opinion, if you master these three hooks, you can build any app that you like. This is a bold statement, but I truly believe that it's true. Alrighty, without further ado, let's get started. Perfect. So I'm back to my VS Code editor. This is where we left you in the last video. So in this video, we're gonna learn about another hook called useRef. So I'm gonna create a new variable. I'll say const text inref. In means I am going to use an input field. So this is just a naming convention, and I'll say useRef, and that's how you import it from React. So to use this ref, let's create a text box. Input type will be text, and that's it. And then we can bind this input HTML box with our ref that we created. Notice that this ref attribute is not a part of default HTML. It is something provided to us via React or Next.js. You might see some errors here, but it's okay. This is coming from the TypeScript, and it's okay, we can ignore them. Okay, I'm gonna save the file. I'm gonna go back to our local host, and I'm gonna open the console as well. So since I'm using Chrome browser, to open a console, you have to press Ctrl-Shift-I. And there you go. So plus is working, minus is working. Let me quickly go back and also update the plus so that, you know, everything works the way it should. So the plus is working again, minus is working. I'm gonna remove this. The text box is sitting here, it's not doing anything. And let's see how we can now use the ref to read the data from this text. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna say here, again, since we're not doing anything fancy in this tutorial, we're just gonna log it. I'm gonna say text equals to text inref dot current dot value. So that's how you read value from a text box. So now if I click on plus, you will see that the text appears here. So if I can go here and change my name is GKV, I click here, you see that this pops up. Now I think that this useRef hook is also super powerful and super useful, because many of the times in your app development, you would need to know, or you need to refer to one of the text boxes, or maybe one of the buttons, or maybe one of the text areas. For example, you might need a useRef to run some data validation. Now since I put it there, I can actually show you a quick demo of it. So I can say, for example, const t equals to, I know that's not the best practice, but I think time being it's okay. And I can say if not t, or t is equals to undefined. t is equals to nothing. I'm gonna say log. Please type something. This basically means that with this value, now you can do any kind of data validation that you like. If I go here, things work fine. If I remove this, now we say it says please type something. And of course, I forgot to say return. And without that return statement, this statement is also executed, which you don't want. Beautiful. All right, logic lovers, that's all for this video. In the next one, we will learn about components. See you there. And before you click on the next video, do not forget to subscribe and like the video. It motivates me to create more videos for you. Also, you can use the comment section to let me know what other things you would like to learn, and I will try to create that tutorial for you.